Some Longwood city leaders and business owners are all celebrating tonight. An old grocery store building, which has been a vacant eyesore for nearly two decades, is finally being demolished. WESH's Dave McDaniel live at the shopping plaza, where out with the old is considered by many to be long overdue, Dave.
Absolutely long overdue, Martha. You know, for people who work and own businesses in this area, you're looking at the sore thumb. This supermarket, which closed back in the mid-90s, but has been standing here extremely visible for the thousands of cars that use 434 each and every day. For this building to finally come down, for the folks around here, is clearly a fresh start. For area businesses and local workers, this is a much needed, long overdue first step.
I was crossing the street and saw the crane, and I was like, yes, it's happening today.
Longwood city leaders posed for a photo to commemorate the day. Nearly as good as a ribbon cutting is getting rid of a building which has been empty 18 years plus, a building with asbestos and other issues. A building nobody wanted.
It would have cost any developer just to retrofit, you know, millions of dollars. So nobody wanted to come in here.
On the market for years, the city worked extra hard with the bank which owned the place to let it go, to clear the decks. The city commissioned some drawings years ago, part of the dream of what the area might be.
Hey, this is the closure of old type Longwood and moving into new Longwood.
Across the street, they remodeled a couple years ago, and they're doing very well over there. I think we can do the same here.
Nearby workers just want the building out of the way, so their shops are noticed.
They would come in and go, I didn't know this hair salon was here. We've been here for 12 years, 13 years, long time.
And city leaders tell me that they now have developers finally interested in this property. That is, once the building is down once and for all, and all the pieces and parts have been picked up and hauled away. Reporting live in Longwood, Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.